I would like to welcome and thank everyone, parents, family, friends, faculty, school board, community, and especially the class of 2020. I'm Laurel Browning, your superintendent, and it's an honor to be here today. The class of 2020 will be greatly missed, and most of us can testify to their incredible academic achievements, passionate performances, and memorable competitions. But this group of seniors is so much more than grade point averages, concerts, and championships. This class is unique, not because of what they've done, but how they've done it. They've taken great care of one another and have given back to the community. Class of 2020, here's a thought I'd like to share with you, and one I have used with my own children. The secret to anyone's success is what I call, and then some. These three little words are very powerful. They're the difference between average people and those who excel. People who excel do what's expected, and then some. They're thoughtful and kind and caring, and then some. They meet their responsibilities fairly and squarely, and then some. They're helpful neighbors, and they help others and can be counted in tough times, and then some. Your life is worth a noble cause. I wish each of you success in the path you choose to travel. May you be caring and courageous and make our world a better place. It has been an honor and a privilege to be part of your journey. Congratulations on a job well done.
Class of 2020, congratulations. Today is your day. You're off to great places. You're off and away. Hello, everyone. My name is Jeff Baines, and I am honored to be the principal at Burlington-Edison High School. I want to welcome everyone this evening as we celebrate and honor the class of 2020 and their families. We are also proud of each and every graduate for their determination, dedication, commitment to the arriving at this joyous event. I cannot tell you all how proud I am of each and every one of you for all the work and effort that you've put into getting here this evening. You are truly a special group of young men and women. Tonight, I want to share some wise words from the great Dr. Seuss and a few wise words of my own. At least I hope you think they're wise. So with that, here I go. Congratulations, today is your day. You're off to great places, you're off and away. You have brains in your head, you have feet in your shoes. You can steer yourself any direction you choose. You're on your own and you know what you know, and you are the person who decide where you'll go. Oh, the places you'll go. You will come to a place where the streets are not marked. Some windows are lighted, but mostly are dark. A place you could sprain both elbow and chin. Do you dare stay out? Do you dare go in? How much can you lose? How much can you win? And if you go in, should you turn left or right in 3/4? Or maybe not quite, or go around back and sneak in from behind. Simple it's not, I'm afraid you will find. For a mind maker upper to make up their mind, oh, the places you'll go. And will you succeed? Yes, you will indeed. 98.75% guaranteed. Kid, you'll move mountains. Before I end this evening with one last amazing Dr. Seuss quote, I want to share some wise words for all of you. In fact, really one word, or should I say a hashtag. Hashtag B-E-H-S all in. By now you've probably seen this on a Twitter post, an email, or maybe you just heard me saying it. My message to the class of 2020 is this: be all in. No matter what you do or where you go, do not settle for anything less than your best. Be all in. Keep moving forward, no matter what the circumstances may put in front of you, as no circumstance will dictate your future. Just be all in. And on that given day, the world seems to be heavy on your shoulders. Remember, you are strong. You can endure. You will persevere. You will come out on top. Just be all in. And if you need a shoulder to lean on, I will be there. Just let me know. It might be tomorrow. It might be a year. It might be 20. Who's to say? No matter what, I will be there for you, the class of 2020. Why? Because I am BEHS all in. And on that given day that everything falls your way, don't slow down. Keep moving forward and find a way to make this day better than any other. Be all in. You will move mountains. You will make a difference. You will change lives. Put it all together and you're going to change the world. Just remember to pursue life with a passion and a huge heart. And in other words, just be all in. So, be your name Buckspawn or Bixby or Bray or Mordecai Alley Van Alley O'Shea. You're off to great places. Today is your day. Your mountain is waiting, so get on your way. Burlington Edison Class of 2020, you will forever be in my heart. Congratulations. At this time, I would like to introduce Assistant Principal Jeff Demarest to share about our scholarships and awards.
Class of 2020, you are truly a remarkable group. It's been such a blessing to be a part of your high school experience. Mr. Rogers was the host of a children's television show in the 60s, which ran through my childhood. Now, students, a television show, they're sort of like YouTube videos, only they're not on your phone, and stuff's on just once. But Mr. Rogers was so much more than entertainment. He sought to help people understand the world around us, and in a way that would help shape our character. You know that the 60s and the 70s were times of significant social strife, much like today. Mr. Rogers was forward-thinking, tackling important issues with love and compassion. And remember, he spoke to small children, but he did it in a way that reached us all. During one episode, he said something so profound that I want to share it with you today. You might have actually seen it in a meme. Parents, a meme is sort of like a commercial, but it's on your phone, and it's usually some sort of inside joke, which is why we don't usually get it. But Mr. Rogers said when he was a small boy and he saw something scary on the news, his mother would say, "Look for the helpers. You will always find people who are helping." Wow, those are powerful words. Not that looking for helpers makes more helpers or even makes underlying problems go away. But Mr. Rogers knew what we all know. You are much more likely to see what you're looking for. And if you look for the best in the world, you are likely to be inspired to contribute your best. I have the privilege of describing the scholarships awarded to the class of 2020. We've made the names of the recipients available to you online. You can see the URL in a program to the right of the list of graduates, or you can use the QR code. Parents, that's the, how do I describe a QR code? Look for the spot that looks like the cable went out on your television. Wave your camera over it and see what happens. What you're going to see is an overwhelming display of success and support. College and military institutions are paying top dollar to entice our graduates. They see the challenging classes that you took, the grades that you earned, and the experiences you have filled your lives with, and they want you to be a part of their programs. You'll also see an outpouring of support from our community. Rotaries, churches, unions, and foundations work throughout the year raising money to support you. The Burlington Edison Education and Alumni Foundation does an especially nice job of supporting our students and also supports other organizations by facilitating their scholarship awards. All told, support for our students annually is measured in millions of dollars. That's pretty impressive and a great example of looking for the best. These organizations look for the best attributes in our students and are inspired to help. Our students, heading to post-secondary options, reach out for partnerships and find an abundance of opportunity. Class of 2020, as your high school experience comes to a close, I encourage you to always look for the helpers. You will always find people who are helping.
Thank you, Mr. Demarest. Each year at graduation, we recognize the tremendous accomplishments of students who complete their high school careers with a perfect 4.0 GPA, earning an A in every class. These students earn the title of class valedictorian and are asked to speak at the graduation ceremonies. This year, the class of 2020 has 6 valedictorians. 6 of our amazing students have attained that distinguished honor. It is with great pride tonight that I get to introduce them all to you. Our first valedictorian I'd like to recognize this evening is Jocelyn Kruger. Jocelyn is the daughter of Chad and Tanya Kruger. Jocelyn has one brother, Zachary, and one sister, Alexis, a 2018 BE grad. Jocelyn has participated in both dance and cheer during her 4 years at BEHS. Next year, Jocelyn will attend Washington State University as an honor college grad student. Our first valedictorian that has chosen to speak this evening is Aya Ochiai. Aya is the daughter of Tom Ochiai and Meg Tanaka. Aya has one sibling attending the UW, June. Aya has participated in Interact Club as president, Science Olympiad, founder and president, band, mathlete, key club, varsity and volunteerism, choir, drama, and track. Aya will attend Yale University and major in engineering. Please join me in welcoming Miss Aya Ochiai to the podium.
I've heard it said that people come into our lives for a reason, bringing something we must learn, and we are led to those who help us most to grow if we let them, and we help them in return. Well, I don't know if I believe that's true, but I know I'm who I am today because I knew you. Like a comet pulled from orbit as it passes a sun, like a stream that meets a boulder halfway through the wood. Say if I've been changed for the better, but because I knew you, I have been changed for good. It well may be that we will never meet again in this lifetime. So let me say before we part, so much of me is made of what I've learned from you. You'll be with me like a handprint on my heart. And now whatever way our stories end, I know you have rewritten mine by being my friend. Like a ship blown from its mooring by a wind off the sea, like a seed dropped by a sky bird in a distant wood, who can say if I've been changed for the better, but because I knew you, because I knew you, I have been changed for good. And just to clear the air, I ask forgiveness for the things I've done you blame me for. But then I guess we know there's blame to share, and none of it seems to matter anymore. Like a comet pulled from
like a ship
orbit
as from
it passes
by a wind off the sea,
like a stream that meets
like
a
seed dropped by a bird in the wood.
Who can say if I've been changed for the better? I do believe I have been changed for the better. And because I knew you,
because I knew you, because I knew you,
I have been changed.
Our next valedictorian is Miss Emily Powers. Emily is the daughter of Jay and Paula Powers. Emily has one brother, Ian, who is a freshman here at Burlington-Edison High School. Emily has participated in drama, mathletes, natural helpers, mentorships, choir, student advisory council, honor society, and serves as a teacher for Christ the King Skagit Kids. Emily will attend Eastern Washington University to major in children's studies. Please join me in welcoming Miss Emily Powers to the podium.
It is not always wise to take advice from TV, but there are moments where it beautifully sums up the human experience. Like this quote from Parks and Rec's Chris Traeger: "How we deal with tragedy defines who we are." Our current global health crisis is much bigger than any problem tackled in the fictitious town of Pawnee, Indiana, but I think a lot can still be learned from Traeger's quote. The impacts of COVID-19 haven't been easy on anyone. As we have shut ourselves away, we have seen our loved ones and fellow humans battle a virus both in their bodies and on the front lines. It's safe to say our world will never be the same. At the same time, our nation has hit a tipping point as the murders of George Floyd and countless others have revealed just how deep roots of racism and injustice run in the place we call home. Tragedy has changed our world countless times. In fact, most of us were born within a year of September 11th, 2001. Of course, the world was so new to us when we were babies, so big. We knew nothing of the news outside our immediate surroundings. The people around us kept saying things would never be the same, and they weren't. New security measures, policies, and prejudices altered the world we were just being introduced to in the same way germs, distance, and closures, posts, protests, and petitions are now shaping our entrance into adult life. We are a class bookended by life-altering tragedies. And while these events are forever important to remember, to learn from, while we should always honor those who have given their time, who have lost their lives, it is not the events in our lives which define us. It's the choices we make in response. As the class of 2020, we are in a unique position. In the midst of change, the world turns its eyes to us, first to see how we handle our exit, and then how we face the new challenges in front of us. As we begin our journey today, I believe it is important to choose gratitude. We are surrounded by people who have loved us, challenged us, celebrated our moments of success, and given us support in times of weakness. To our parents and guardians who have seen us through life's moments, big and small, and never given up on us, thank you. We all come from different places and have different stories, but there is one group of people who have stood by our sides no matter what. To the staff of the Burlington-Edison School District, thank you. Some of us have been here 13 years, others only one, but regardless, we are here today because of you. You go beyond your official job description every day to extend extra kindness, time, heart, patience, and effort towards us. I firmly believe there is not one student here who has not been impacted by you. And to my two favorite teachers, Mom and Dad, thank you for everything and for making every day take your daughter to work day. While so much credit is due to the adults in our lives, we also owe a lot to one another. The relationships we've built and the stories we've shared turned even the worst moments of our high school careers into something we could get through. We were the freshmen who had to evacuate Kirkby Field one September night when our town became the backdrop to a senseless act of violence. But we were also the class who came back to school the next Monday and every day after together. We are the young people watching, posting, protesting as our country confronts its inherent racism in a new and innovative way. We are the seniors who don't get to be together today, but we only hurt so much because of every good moment we have to remember. Bursts of laughter during class, drives down country roads at sunsets, late night practices, hellos in hallways, astonishing wins and stellar performances, early morning coffee runs, inside jokes, good cries, big smiles, long days, bright moments. Gratitude, perseverance, understanding, community. No one promised us life would be easy, and as we go into a more adult world, that will only become more true. But it's how we deal with tragedy that defines who we are. Even though today may not look how we wanted, there is still so much to be grateful for and to look forward to. The world is looking to us for our response, our reaction, our readiness to adapt to all the changes being thrown our way. They call us the class of COVID-19, but we're the class of memories made, of challenges faced, of victories big and small. So here's to where we've been together, and each place we'll go next, in the midst of tragedy, celebration, and everything in between.
Our next valedictorian to share her speech with us tonight is Bronte Lacey. Bronte is the daughter of Marilana and Steve Lacey. Bronte has participated in 4 years of volleyball and softball, cheer, honor society, interact club, choir, BEHS mentor program, student advisory committee, and is a 3-time ASB class secretary and current ASB activities director. Bronte will be attending Washington State University next fall. Please join me in welcoming Ms. Bronte Lacey to the podium.
Congratulations, BEHS Class of 2020. I feel honored to be speaking to you on our graduation day. Our lives are about to change. Yes, even beyond what's happened recently with COVID-19, it's about to change even more for us. To be honest, I've never been very comfortable with change. I've lived in the same house my whole life, next door to our same neighbors my whole life. Once I develop a habit, good or bad, I tend to resist new suggestions to avoid failure. Just ask my coaches, they know. I'll rewatch Grey's Anatomy 3 times before starting a new show. And when my Ford Explorer was totaled, I talked my grandma into letting me have hers, which is almost identical to my old one. I could go on and on. I am comfortable with what's familiar. I guess that's why I've been pretty disheartened, and maybe even a little resentful, about senior year stopping abruptly, leaving my class without spring sports, awards assemblies, our final and most important dance, prom, sneakily following people for senior assassins, being able to wear sandals and skirts on springy days, and just experiencing the excitement of sunny last days together. And finally, we're all leaving without our huge anticipated graduation ceremony, with everyone we love all in one place on our beloved Kirkby Field. We've looked forward to the sunset of senior year our whole lives, but without warning, our time together ended. I'll admit, with all the disappointment of senior year cut short, I had a terrible time trying to convey a positive message to leave our class. It took me a while to come around to the realization that if any high school class is prepared for change, it's the class of 2020. We are post 9/11 kids. We know what to do if we see an abandoned backpack. We know how to shelter in place in the classroom and run zigzag to avoid a shooter. We're experienced with mall shootings and bridge collapses. And now we've experienced a viral pandemic. I believe that the class of 2020 was faced with this challenging pandemic to let us know we are bigger than the changes in our lives. Each one of us are bigger than the changes and challenges we've grown up to know and remember. And we're about to prove it. Our class doesn't have to define success monetarily. We will define it by improving humanity in big and small ways. We aren't the only generation to be tasked with fighting climate change and mass shootings, or eliminating racial and social injustice. But we are equipped to make a dent in these issues. If we can only remind ourselves now and again what we've lived through when we were young and how capable we actually became. I see the success of Class of 2020 more like a beam of light running through each of us. For every selfless decision or act, the beam shines brighter. Our class has the choice, and maybe even the expectation, to build beauty and goodness from the inside without comparison to monetary wealth. Whichever ways our individual careers or life plans turn out, let's do our best to make a mark in the ways that work for each of us. It may be in the type of work we choose, or it may not. Some will give monetarily, others will fight for injustice from their digital platforms or help run support groups. Some might volunteer to visit with lonely elders in retirement homes or animals in shelters, or simply become diligent recyclers from home. It doesn't matter how we do it, just that we do it in our own unique ways. Those life connections we make and keep will be how we find our joy. It's how we will stay grounded and truly connected with our world. We have the choice to organize our lives this way. We will be successful if we feel we're making a difference. I can't wait to see the ways that our class of 2020 will make our differences and find our successes. We made it. Happy graduation to every one of us.
Our next valedictorian and speaker is Miss Katie King. Katie is the daughter of Roland and Ramey King. Katie has an older sister, Rachel, and brother, Bowen, both attending BYU Provo, and brothers, Charlie, a current Tiger, and Jensen from Bayview Elementary. Katie has participated as a 4-year varsity letter winner in volleyball, basketball, and track and field. Along with that, Katie is involved with leadership, key club, choir, all 4 years as an ASB or class officer, green club, mentorship program, natural helpers, honor society, and 4 years of seminary. Katie will be attending Western Washington University, playing volleyball, and studying education and exercise science. Please join me in welcoming Miss Katie King to the podium.
When I learned that I was going to get to speak at graduation, I was not expecting to be here in the pack speaking to a camera. However, no matter the circumstances, I'm so grateful for this opportunity, and I'd like to start by thanking everyone who helped me get to where I am today. Thank you first to all of my teachers for your choice to come to school every day to sacrifice your time and energy turning students like me into learners and thinkers. To the administration, thank you for the decisions you make daily at Burlington-Edison that turns our school into an environment where I could come to feel safe, to feel important, and to get an education. Thank you to the custodial staff who not only work day and night to keep our school clean and orderly, but who also showed me so much patience on the many late nights that their cleaning was delayed because I just couldn't yet leave the weight room or the gym. Thank you to all of my coaches who spent every day with me after school, pushing me to be a better player and a better person. Thank you to my 4 siblings for all of their love and support, and to my parents. They've sat through hundreds of my games, read over dozens of my essays, and made me countless lunches before rushing me out the door in the morning. And lastly, thank you to each and every classmate, teammate, and friend that I made here at Burlington Edison. Now to my class, the class of 2020. After 13 long years of education, we did it. We're graduating. The moment we've been eagerly awaiting our entire childhoods. And while we're all at the same point now, our experiences that got us here are all vastly different. When I look back on high school, I see myself cheering in the stands at football games until my voice hurt. I see myself on the court or field, hugging my teammates after big wins. I see myself heading to the Tiger Espresso after every semester to get my free drink for making the honor roll. I see myself hanging in a hammock with my best friend Briley at Chuckanut, enjoying a gorgeous Skagit Valley sunset. Now, on a much less glamorous side, I also see myself making the long walk from the gym to my car, holding ice packs on both shoulders and both knees, so sore I'm unsure if I can make it through another practice. I see myself crying in the bathroom sophomore year after Algebra 2 because I couldn't for the life of me come to fathom the concept of polynomials. And I see myself staring out the window of the van on a long ride home after a season-altering loss, wishing that I'd made that last shot or gotten that last dig. For some of you, my experiences may sound very similar to your own. And for many others, these memories don't sound like your high school experience at all. However, no matter the finer details, each of us underwent ups and downs, worse days, and better days. And for every single one of us, our high school experience was cut short. Now, as much as I don't want COVID-19 to define us as the class of 2020, I do think there is much to be learned from this significant historic event that has completely altered our final months of high school. We lost all extra time we thought we would have to make any final lasting impressions on our school, our classmates, and our teachers. As each of us looks back again at our high school memories, I think we can see ourselves with many expectations and intentions that were never met or put into motion. For me, this reality fills me with sadness and regret. And while I truly did love high school, it still makes me, as I look back at all those previously mentioned experiences, wonder if I would have acted with more urgency. If I would have altered my priorities. If I knew that my time at Burlington Edison would be shorter than initially expected. After the big wins, would I have spent less time worrying about my stats or how that game would set us up for the postseason? In what I've spent more time celebrating with my teammates and coaches. At social events, what I've spent less time trying to get the perfect picture for my Instagram, and what I've spent more time laughing, loving, and cherishing the people around me. In school, what I've spent less energy stressing about keeping a perfect 4.0
and more energy on showing my appreciation to my teachers and making better relationships with my classmates. Now, I don't want to give the wrong idea here. I do highly value hard work, but I firmly believe that it should not be done at the expense of relationships with others. This is the hard lesson I've learned as I look back on how many of my relationships in high school suffered as I prioritized what I then thought was the end-all be-all. Class of 2020, I urge us all, as we move forward with our lives, no matter what path you take, to work hard, to strive toward your goals. But as you do this, love the moment and love those around you. Make relationships with more substance, and then prioritize those relationships always. Because the next time a part of your life gets cut short, you don't want to look back and wish you'd put less time into materialistic measures of success. Live with more urgency and more love, and less procrastination and regret. We are not promised tomorrow, and we must remember that intending to do is not nearly as powerful as doing. So 2020 graduates, congratulations to us all. And here's to a new chapter of our lives. It's a chapter of uncertainty and possibility, but it's also an opportunity to live life with more meaning, purpose, and love.
Our sixth valedictorian and final speaker for the evening is Miss Rachel Husband. Rachel is the daughter of Susan and Troy Husband. Rachel has an older brother, Luke, and older sister, Shannon, that both currently attend Whitman College. Rachel has participated in varsity swim and dive, named one of our co-captains, international competitor in DECA, Science Olympiad, Interact Club, Key Club, Mentorship Program, Honor Society, and Mathlete. Rachel will be joining her brother and sister this fall at Whitman College. Please join me in welcoming Miss Rachel Husband to the podium.
Well, here we are. Let me tell you, I've imagined giving this speech for 4 years now, and it's exactly as I pictured. I mean, wow, you all look so great. I don't know about you, but as a newly minted graduate, I don't feel a whole lot different than I did yesterday. Quite honestly, today feels just like another day. Today doesn't feel special. This is not to undervalue the incredible efforts Mr. Baines, the staff, the administration, and really all of the school district have gone to celebrate us. In fact, I think this graduation might be far superior to what we would have normally had. Instead of being trapped in a smelly, steaming tent for hours upon hours with the dear people in our geometry classes, we have the unique opportunity to graduate from the comfortable confines of our own beds. If that's not a tribute to the class of 2020, I don't know what is. Today, it might be pouring outside or the hottest day of the year, but it doesn't matter either way because we don't have to do that silly little two-step through the flower arches. Today, when you cross the stage, you won't have to squint against the blinding rays of the sun, scrunching your face into a hideous mask as your grandma films the tiny speck that is you on her iPhone 5 from about a mile away. Instead, you will be pleasantly lit by fluorescent bulbs and professional lighting. You can fast forward through these never-ending speeches to watch yourself take those few steps to freedom again and again in high definition if you so choose. This graduation, by any means, is quite luxurious. So, the reason that today doesn't feel special is because, quite frankly, it's not. Thousands of kids are graduating. Thousands of parents and grandparents are watching videos of their kids graduating. It is not a unique experience. And yet, somehow it still matters. It matters that we're graduating. But this day is one day among thousands in our lives. This one moment cannot encapsulate the entirety of our years at Burlington or the essence of who we are. We use this distinctly unspecial moment to say, nice work, and be happy for a little while, and to smile and wave at all the special people in our lives. We got to this place because of them, and we owe them our gratitude. Hey, Mom. Hey, Dad. Thanks. This moment is not special because of what it is, but because of what came before it. You do not feel joy at the end of a race because you stand and exist on the finish line. If that were the case, then no one would ever run races, and people would just drive their cars right to the end and get out. No, you feel joy because of all the steps it took to get to the finish line. But this one final step is not very different from the rest, not very special at all. What is special is the amount of steps one has taken. To be clear, I'm not talking in literal terms. I really hate running. But what I mean is each day that got us to this place, including today, are essentially all the same. The sun rose and set, and tomorrow it will assuredly do the same. Now, you may ask, is this merely a thinly veiled version of the cliche, the journey is more important than the destination? Yeah, it is, but that doesn't mean I won't scrape some speech material out of it. Tomorrow might not be special either. So how do we even attempt to make meaning in our lives when few moments seem special? How do we stop ourselves from being lost in the passages of time? How do we know when the time is right to act? Meaning comes from the choices we make today, the most normal of days. So I will end my speech in the most stereotypical of ways, with a call to action. Today, graduation day, is the destination. The journey has been everything that has come before and everything that will come after. So to the graduating class of 2020, you have the choice to make today and all of the rest of your days mean something. Step carefully.
As the superintendent of the Burlington-Edison School District, I certify that this class of 2020 has met all the state and district requirements. Congratulations, graduates.
The end or a beginning? Not really the way you thought your senior year would end, right? But here we are. So let's do what we do best. Take charge and make the best of our situation. My name is Walter Jones. I was a professional football player for the Seattle Seahawks. And yes, I have met Marshawn. He is cool, like really cool. No, I can't get his autograph. He still owes me a jersey. So you would just have to wait. I am here today to share a message of hope, a message that I hope will be with you for years to come. Not the message I wish I was giving you today, but one I am happy to share with you. Life is challenging, unpredictable, but I gotta tell you, you is a wonderful ride, and the beauty of it, you don't have to be a football player to have a good life. Actually, sometimes my knees hurt. If you can make a living doing something other than football, do it. But why are we here today? Well, much like you, I had an unconventional high school experience. I had to adjust to new goals, a new reality, but a reality that afforded me a chance to focus and take life by the horns. And yes, I understand your pain. You was robbed of lifelong experiences, prom, graduation, musicals, choir recitals, getting in trouble. Looking at you, Oliver. And honestly, that is sad. So you should be angry. You should be sad. You should be able to articulate your pain, and you should process it and write me a 5-page essay due tomorrow. Wait, I can't do that to you. Okay, my bad. Fun fact, I wanted to be a teacher. Well, a coach? Okay, an assistant coach. Okay, I just wanted to make kids run. My coach did it to me. I wanted to pass it down. Then again, I bet many of you would trade a few laughs for a chance to live your normal senior year, to be able to do all those things you plan to do. I once learned that waiting for the next chance to do can turn into a missed opportunity. So let's make a pledge that from now on, you will try that new language, that new hard class, that new job, that new song. You will be known as the generation of doing instead of wishing. Why? Simple. You had planned it too. You was robbed of it. And now you no longer wish, you just do. Go out into the world and make a dent in history books. Get to write them. You get to write them. You get to live it and you get to dictate how you are remembered. So don't be the generation that was robbed of their senior year. Be the generation that was given a lesson many of us learned later on in life. Do, don't just wish. Congratulations, the class of 2020. Much love, Uncle Walt.
Joel Linares Salgado. Emily Rachel Powers. Aya Ochiai. Shannon Ray Allen. Bronte Shannon Lacey. Rachel Nicole Husband. Katie Rice King. Miranda Zella Browning. JC Abenroth. Raina Alanis. Briley Axelson Nye. Jocelyn Kruger. Christian Arabos. Savannah Candia. Briseida Hernandez Zamora. Kennedy Anderson. Shaylin Anderson. Hayden Anderson. Eric Altenhoffen. Holly Marie Bombach. Emma Burns. Chloe Brady. Abigail Barr. Marianne Ammons. Ashley Dale Brooks. Cody Powell Burrows. Lucas Barney. Khadijah Butler. Abigail Bagyan. Adrian Paul Barnett. Joseph Hamilton Broda. Diego Corona Lemos. Carson Cecinia. Ayuka Carlson. Daisy Cortez. Nathan Belisle. Alejandro Carrillo. Donovan DJ Clark. Colby Michael Castani. Jose Chavez. Tate Kavanaugh. Aitza Cabrera Chavez. Nicholas Cavazos. Faith Marie Castellanos Kerwin. Dawson Tyner Metcalf. Emily De Leon. John Ryan Howard. Spencer Allen Day. Caitlin May Duval. Lauren Lene Dykstra. Genevieve Ann Elton. Samantha Susanna Elton. Owen Dreyer. Luke Culkett. Lily Grace Edwards. Jasmine Joy Evans. Emma Irene Isis. Madison Durkin. Bridget Mateo Rico. Jocelyn Evans. Ali Ellis. Austin Jeffrey Frazier. Alexander Kale Denny. Alfonso Garcia Lopez. Aaliyah Farler. Megan Marie Grenier. Aiden John Eddy. Roxanne Flores Torres. Kylia Renee Friedland. Austin J. Graham. Alexis Garcia Arribeño. Jonathan Garcia Reyes. Hugo Garcia Cruz. Isaiah Alex Garcia. Aaliyah Marie Gonzalez. Eduardo Gallardo. Sophia Ann Felix. Roberto Gonzalez. Jennifer Garcia Tovar. Chloe Marie Heinz. Alexis Sophie Galen. Juliana Jane Fowler. Kaylee Evans Hathcock. Ayana Hansen. Taylor Isaacs. Freya Hoskinson. Brady Algett Hemmingson. Owen Lee Holmes. Ollie Matthew Hahn. Griffin Hink. Andrew Wesley Henry. Ethan Mile Hill. Ethan Miles Hill. Cody Harrison Hurd. Trenton Quinn Hendricks. Alex Willem Heller. Brianne Haley Heckel. Maria Belen Herrera. Angel Hernandez Martinez. Marco Alexander Hernandez Rodriguez. Emily Huerta Lopez. Carissa Ashley Kreider. Dylan May Isaacson. Lissa June Kilgo. William Knudsen. Nick Kinney. Hannah Jolie Knutson. Allison Ann Lane. Brett David Johnson. Lillian Christine Crone. Luis Fernando Lopez Aguilar. Tucker Jordan. Yvette Torres. Adrian Giovanni Ibarra. Caleb Livingston. Torsten Dane Lund. Carson Avery Lee. Savannah Louise Lee. Molly Jolene Livers. Cole Edwin Logan. Elsie Amy Lee. Isaac Martin Lantis. Emily May Larson. Caleb Keone Myers. Evan Douglas Larson. Adela Marie Hernandez. Litzy Ruby Rodriguez. Kaylee Jo Mortensen. Drew Mendoza. Sawyer Wilcox Moore. Chloe Zane Myers. Jaime Mendoza. Eugenia López Maclovio. Emma May Miller. Grace Elizabeth Miller. Ashton Davis Martinez. Aaliyah Marie Mora. Angelina Mejia Morales. Sinaí Mendoza. Cora Jane Orton. Abby O'Dwyer. Ben Mendoza. Moira McKay. Connor Roy North. Adiel Alexander Puerto. Bianca Palomera Sanchez. Brianna Kathleen Nelson. Jennifer Ramirez. Kylie Puente Ibarra. Alyssa Marie Peck. Angel Luis Navarro. Olga Pakrova. Bailey K. Obin. Charles Burtis Rasko. Carlos Francisco Roques. Jordan Christopher Rogers. Edgar Rincon. Ryan Thomas Riggs. Diego Andres Ruiz. Kerry Richmond Stanek. Geraldine Ramirez Barriga. Beatriz Ramirez Vázquez. Jackson Westendorf Reisner. Preston Miguel Rivas. Grace Elizabeth Selvig. Samuel Rodriguez Ramirez. Jasper Scott. Emily Serrano Sariñana. Raúl Serrano Andrade. Cecilia Leticia Regosa Delgado. Jessica Isabel Rao. Brandy Elizabeth Stewart. Cody James Springer. John Towner Seth. Summer Ray. Victor Santos Morales. Jasmine Rose Sanchez. Stephanie San Juan Chino. Anika Schlimmer. David Sakuma. Zoe Shadle. Kaylee Ann Stucker. Alex Joseph Thurmond. Nathan Dennis Van Beek. Jackson Tanasi Wilson. Samantha Renee Stormo. Wyatt Walker. Kaylee Elise Weathers. Philip Zaremba. Daisy Workman. Ryan Dale Williard. Brendan Tully. Chandler Wilhonen. Saira Vasquez. Logan Jacob Wright. Frederick Yates. David Lopez Ventura. Hugo Alexis Diaz Carranza. Unable to attend, Julissa Rodriguez Jacinto, Nolan White, Carson Pell, Jorge Gaitan Sierra.
If you could all join me for the turning of the tassel, we'll turn our tassels from right to left on three. One, two, three. Congratulations! Woo!
Hi, my name's Ethan Lemos, and I am with Life and Light.
And I'm Scott Krenz, and I'm with Joustins.
Class of 2020, we hope you enjoyed your virtual graduation experience.
As we've partnered through this experience, I've learned a lot about Life and Light. Look forward to learning more, but they want to give back. In fact, for the first time that I can remember, you're going to have an opportunity to have free downloads of the images that they've taken. The way in which you do that is follow the link here across your screen and enjoy it.